What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to the channel. I appreciate you guys clicking on the video today, as we will be doubling back on a previous video, and I just want to elaborate on a little bit of something and present some information to you guys. If you are finding my channel and videos for the very first time, I am Dutch the Creator, and this is Inside the Culture Podcast, and this will be episode 13. All right, folks, I put out a video the other day where this black woman was basically talking about women who, and especially black women, she said, who choose a child support check over a man being in the house. The video was not about if men should be fathers or how they are viewed as being deadbeat dads or anything. That wasn't what the video was about, but a lot of women do come and they come from the emotional side and come with a whole nother aspect. I mean, it's apples and oranges. The woman was literally talking about, matter of fact, I'm going to play it right again on what she was talking about. Okay, right now, let's go.
I just watched the video and I'm so embarrassed, bro. I'm so embarrassed. This guy was going around asking women, and mostly black women, asking these women, what would you rather have? Would you rather have a broke guy who's still a father and who's at home, you know, and around for your kids, but he broke? Or would you rather have a financially stable man and pay the child support? My heart is racing, y'all. Do you know every last one of these bitches said that they would rather have the check? Every one of them just said they would rather have a check.
So the topic of the video, which I like people to stay on topic and not bring in other things, because it's other videos that could be for what you're asking or what you're talking about. The thing is, stay on the video's topic, and the video's topic of that video was how women literally just choose the bag over the man being in the children's lives. And that's what she said. That's all she was saying. Now, you can comment on the topic, and I don't mind you asking me, hey, do you mind doing a video about deadbeat dads who are not in their children's lives? I can do that video. That's a part of our culture, so I can do that video. But when it comes to the child support system, it's a lot of misconceptions out there to make it feel like men can just, you know, go down to the court and get respected. It is not like that. And these women and some men, you actually know that. You know what the child support system actually does to a community, period. Black, white, Hispanic, I don't care. It literally hinders the man who wants to be in his child's life. What I'm saying is this: when men want to be in their children's life, I don't care if they can pay or they can't pay. He still have a right to be in the child's life. Now, we can talk about the man who don't want to pay child support or can't pay child support. We can talk about that. But as far as that man being in that child's life, if that's all he can offer, if that's all he can do, I myself don't see nothing wrong with that man seeing his children. You see, because we're going to talk about a comment that was made, and this guy Dion Kellogg, he basically broke down what I'm talking about. And from a female's point of view, they don't get what men get in the courts. Like they get to see them kids, they get to take a class, and now the crackhead woman could literally just see. They make sure that they get these women to see their children, and that is a fact. That is a fact. So without further ado, I want you guys to take a look at the first comment, and Dion Kellogg, he is going to be responding to that comment. I'm gonna read it off. Says no parent should abandon their children. Now, again, this is not about abandoning their children. The video is not about that. The video is literally about women choosing child support over a man in the children's life. So let's get back to it. No parent should abandon their children. I don't know any court that gives visitation without making the non-custodial parent pay. This is the internet, though. You can tell us anything. Two different baby mothers, and none of them sticking around. If you were a woman, you would tell them to choose better. I think you should stop dating and focus on your children. Now, Dion Kellogg came with this. Thanks for the advice. I've been single for 5 years now, and I have no plans of getting back into the dating world anytime soon. I was married to my daughter's mom at a young age, and I guess I was a poor judge of character, or maybe I was an asshole and pushed her to make the bad decision she made. My son's mother and I were never married and was a good woman. She is suffering from a mental illness, and we pray for her at bedtime every night. I want my children to have good moms because they deserve that, and I have guilt for how things have ended up. My point is, the state I live in isn't interested in making mothers take financial responsibility for their children the way they do fathers. I have a decent job and an amazing family, so we make it, but the system is bullshit. And that's what I was talking about in the video, which you guys can go watch that video. The system is bullshit. The way the system is set up, it is for women completely, you know? And like I said in my last video, it was set up for different reasons back in 1947 with FDR. You see, it was for these people coming home from the war, these men coming home, and they have PTSD. You see? PTSD, I'm sorry. And they were getting divorces from their wives, or their wives was getting divorces from them because they couldn't handle certain things in the house. And, you know, these men were going batshit crazy. So at the end of the day, these women didn't have jobs. And the government was like, okay, let's do it like this. The men that's basically, you know, divorcing these women, or these women are getting divorced from, we need something to where they can take care of the children. That is totally different from what child support is today. It is literally made up. Matter of fact, you don't even have to be the actual father. If you get tricked on signing that birth certificate and the courts know that you are not the father, you're literally responsible for that child financially. And that is just not fair. It is just not, it's men do get a bad rap in this child support court system. I just wanted to get up here and reiterate some things and continue this conversation, because there's a lot of misinformation out there that I feel that that make men, and I'm not even saying that, you know, it isn't men out here who most definitely don't give a shit about their kid. I am not saying that, people. But what I am saying is, it is a system designed to make men's lives difficult based upon a decision that they made in life. And it's not equal across the board when it comes to women. Okay? And I'm not trying to be controversial here. Like I said on the last video, my ex-wife did not place me on child support. We do 50-50. You know what I mean? We co-parent. So at the end of the day, I believe that's how it should be. But look, man, it's a lot of misconceptions out there and misinformation. Y'all continue to go down in the comment section and give me your opinions on it, and give me your experiences as well. The thing is, appreciate Dion Kellogg giving that experience and understanding what this system actually is. And I hope his ex-wife does get better with that mental illness. Shout out to you, sir. Continue to pray for her. That's all I got. Y'all stay unplugged from false narratives. I'm out. Peace. Catch you on the next one.